Memories of West Street and Lepke by Robert Lowell. Only teaching on Tuesdays, bookworming, in pajamas fresh from the washer each morning. I hog a whole house in Boston's hardly passionate Marlborough Street, where even the man, scavenging filth in the back alley trash cans, has two children, a beach wagon, a helpmate, and is a young Republican. I have a 9 months daughter, young enough to be my granddaughter. Like the sun, she rises in her flame flamingo infant's wear. These are the tranquilized 50s, and I am 40. Ought I to regret my seed time? I was a fire-breathing Catholic CO, and made my manic statement, telling off the state and president, and then sat waiting sentence in the bullpen beside a Negro boy with curlicues of marijuana in his hair. Given a year, I walked on the roof of the West Street jail, a short enclosure like my school soccer court, and saw the Hudson River once a day through sooty clothesline entanglements and bleaching khaki tenements. Strolling, I yammered metaphysics with Abramowitz, a jaundice yellow. It's really tan. And flyweight pacifist, so vegetarian. He wore rope shoes and preferred fallen fruit. He tried to convert B. Offen Brown, the Hollywood pimps, to his diet. Hairy, muscular suburban, wearing chocolate double-breasted suits. They blew their tops and beat him black and blue. I was so out of things. I'd never heard of the Jehovah's Witnesses. "Are you a CO?" I asked a fellow jailbird. "No," he answered, "I'm a JW. He taught me the hospital tuck and pointed out the T-shirted back of Murder Incorporated's Tsar Lepke, their piling towels on a rack, or dawdling after his little segregated cellful of things forbidden to the common man, a portable radio, a dresser, two toy American flags tied together with a ribbon of Easter palm. Flabby, bald, lobotomized, he drifted in a sheepish calm, where no agonizing reappraisal jarred his concentration on the electric chair, hanging like an oasis in his air of lost connections.